when a person becomes paralyzed, a level of their independence is also robbed from them. And that affects us psychologically and our spirits. There's a part of us that dies. I've been trying to visualize myself a contraption that would enable me to get up and walk. I thought, well, is it going to be an avatar? Perhaps a robot? And then I received the phone call to try this new technology, the E-Leg.
I've heard from so many people that the first thing that they encounter after an injury or an amputation is the word no. And I think we are demonstrating here that there is no such word as no.
To take my first step in the E-legs was just astounding, because I bent my knee for the first time in 18 years and I placed my heel on the ground, and then I transferred my weight, and then I took another step and another one, and it was so natural, and that was what really gripped me.
E-legs is really built on the platform or the legacy of Hulk. Hulk is an application that we made for the military.
Exoskeleton technologies are considered part of the robotics field. If you want to think about them as wearable robots, that's pretty accurate.
In my field of spinal cord injury, we work with people who typically are paralyzed for the rest of their life. For the first time in history, we can start to think about giving movement back.
This can become the first rehabilitative device. After someone's injured, they go from walking right back to walking. While they still have the muscle memory within them, they're able to power up and walk in a very safe, tethered environment. But to keep those muscles firing, to weight bear on their legs, keep the blood circulating, their digestive systems working well, there's huge therapeutic benefits for this device that then will become a preventative measure in the long term, because our bodies are meant to be walking upright and moving. This is not a wave of the future. The E-legs is happening right now. I don't have to be hopeful. This is reality.